Right, this video we're looking at a second method of showing the formula for the area of the trapezium. So again, we're going to name this top half, top length A, bottom one B, and then this vertical height H, as we did last time. I'm actually going to draw another line here to define a rectangle within the trapezium. And now we've got three shapes here. We've got the triangle here, which is identical to this triangle here, and the little rectangle in the middle. So to find the area of the trapezium, all we have to do is add up these three areas. So the area of this rectangle, let's give it rectangle, is equal to A times H, because A is the length of the rectangle, H is the height. That's simple enough. Right, so to find the area of a triangle, we need the base and the height. So what's the base? Well, we're just going to look at one triangle at a time. We're actually going to split this shape in half. So if we take this as the midpoint, then this length, that whole length, is b over 2, and this length, the dotted line, is a over 2, you see, because we've found the midpoint there. So that means this base is b over 2, so the base of the triangle is equal to b over 2 minus a over 2, okay? So that means the area of the triangle, that's a terrible triangle, anyway, there you go. Now, well, that's equal to b over 2 minus a over 2 multiplied by h, then you have to divide it by 2. So we've got 1 quarter b minus a h. But now, to find the area of both these triangles added together, this triangle is identical, so we just multiply this by 2. So we're going to say the area of the trapezium area is equal to AH, so that's the rectangle, plus two lots of this, so that's 1/2 H B minus A. We've got a common factor of H, so we'll draw that out. So now we've got H A plus 1/2 B minus 1/2 A, and that's equal to H 1/2 A plus 1/2 B, and that's equal to 1/2 A plus B H, the same as we got before. So this is just another way of seeing where this formula comes from, because I know a lot of some students just like to remember the formula for areas, I think, well, formulas in general, but a lot of people like to know where they come from or why they are what they are. So here's another little derivation. If you didn't see the previous video, we did another one where we just considered this whole shape as one rectangle that we made in a specific way to give us the area of this trapezium. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this video. There'll be much more to come in the future, so please like and subscribe, and I hope to see you in the next one.